Pishe bava som, Shepherd
Savior of a soul, Lover of a soul.
We are on the Lord's side. We will never give up. We are overcome.
I wrote it because the one I've been saying before, writing before, I begin to imagine just now I'm telling people repent of your sin and pray to God and you see what God will do. In my heart, I'll say, what about if people are repenting now and they are praying and the killing is still continuing? What will happen? How will God really fight this battle? In my heart, too. So, this morning, I said, let me lie down. As I lay down, I saw myself in a city. The city was city of people who are just on their own, doing their own thing, peaceful people. I was imagining, where am I? Because I think I was living in that city. So, all of a sudden, as we were on the street, just moving, I saw smoke all around. I said, what is happening here? For a minute, I saw aeroplane everywhere, shooting bomb, bombarding the city around. Say, hey! Brethren, now I know what all these Syrian people went through. To die is not an easy thing. For you to your eye to be seeing war, and the war is coming to you, the trauma of death is painful. The death before death is worse than the death. My heart was terrified. Say, God, what is this? Before I knew it, the battle was coming, and people were now running closer now, and they were bombing us, packing us closer. Say, God, how do we survive it? How do we survive this? So some few of us, I don't know how those people came, so like now a church now. I say, God, how do we help? God, help us here. You will hear the sound of bomb, thick smoke everywhere. So now closer and closer. I say, God, is this how every one of us here will just die? I said, okay, we are there. And as we were praying, and people running, even some people are even running into the smoke. Bombarding us. So we pray, I heard a voice. He said, I am coming down to see the war by myself. Wow. I look up. He said, I am coming down to see the war by myself. So now I saw myself with some people, really Christian, prayerful Christians. We are in a sort like a hut, but very quiet hut. We are praying, Father, help us. If we die, receive our soul. Father, have mercy. Have mercy. Father, have mercy. All of a sudden, I saw one man just walking, an old man. He was older than every one of us. His face was smiling, very fresh. So look at him. He was doing as if he was also trying not to pray. We're there, bombardment. We're going on now. We now see the bomb dropping. We're still praying. Say, God, if we die, have mercy, forgive us, have mercy, help us, deliver us. It's as if now some days have gone. As we're still praying. So all of a sudden, the old man now look at one young man that will pray with us. Say, come. Because the young man was crying, weeping, Father, have mercy. Save our soul. Father, have mercy. Now, he now speak into my heart, first of all. He said, I want to fight now. I said, I want to fight now. My eye just jammed that man that came in. As my eye jammed him, he smiled. My spirit told me, this one is Jehovah Nissio. This man is God. Oh. God is not terrified. He's not moved. But he just does as if he's praying. But it's, you can't see fear in him. Unlike other of us. So, he now called one of the young men that we pray together. He said, come here. He said, now, I want you to ask anything. And it will be done right now. In my heart, I say, I told you this one is Jehovah Nissi. The young man just stand up, say, with tears out. He said, this war will stop and our land will be recovered. That was what the young man said. That this war might stop and our land will recover back to us. He just said, it is done. As just said, it is done. How he melted all this. Oh.
No.
The jets are all melted.
Jesus.
At a glance, all the smoke, all the bombardment ceased immediately. I mean, it's unexplainable. How all the armies, all the jets, let me tell you something. You are seeing all this army. Don't mind them. This is not exaggeration. If the Lord really want to fight, if the Lord really have mercy upon his children and he want to fight, gather all the army in your world. In a second. Oh. All of a second. Oh. And from there, as I look at the man is always smiling. I just say, it is done. Everywhere. First of all, the first thing that happened was peace came into our hearts. All the smoke. How he dried the smoke up. All we can see now is some particles dropping. All the plane, how he melted them. We're not dropping as you know, when you throw powder. That's all we're not seeing. The plane were dropping. He just stood up and looked at us. a smile, I vanish away.
Thank you, Jesus.
Then he now told me, say, I told you I was coming to see the battle, and I saw it and I fought it.
Hallelujah.
I said, wow.
Jesus.
As I just say, wow, I just opened my eyes. It's as if I have not slept for two. My eye was open and it was so clear. I quickly carried my tablet and went to the editor, this thing, and wrote it. My people, the God we are serving, the God we are serving, I mean, Jehovah. Jehovah Nissi, the mighty man of war.
Hallelujah.
If you have not trusted him, please trust him. If you don't know him, try to know him.
Jesus.
He can come down. No. When he told Abraham, I have come to see by myself if what is happening in Sodom and Gomorrah is true.
It's true.
God do come down. God do come down. I saw him. He spoke when the war was going on. He said, I'm coming to see by myself. And when he came, though I did not know him immediately, but the way he was at, he was, every one of us were crying, hey, Father, mercy, this old man, but younger than us. I pray you be spirit to understand me. He is old, but his freshness is incomparable. The smile alone is healing. The smile alone is medicinal. The smile alone is powerful. If you encounter God,
man,
I tell you, he was not praying, he was just looking at, and there's something that happened. Father, thank you. Before he came, what I was saying was like a hurt, no hurt. But when he now came, you know this, like Jamie here, when they do wound, they will smooth it, now have different color.
Mm-hmm.
And black. No ply wound, no ply wound now. Like this, like cupboard. Cupboard, they smooth it, very smooth, shiny. The place we're not praying now become so they use that to do. And just came in, the house changed, and that became a house of plywood. Very clean, neat. I said, how do this place change? No. As I'm wondering in my heart, something else will be telling me, I told you I will come. I will look at the man, he will smile. We'll be praying. He will talk to me. I really think he will smile. Until it was like after some days, the bombardment was going on. And how they did not drop bomb where we were praying, it was a mystery too. Because I can see, you can see now, bomb everywhere, smoke everywhere. Thank God. May God come to your house in the name of Jesus Christ.
Amen.
Brethren, this is, it's unbelievable. You might not believe it, but it does not change anything.
Amen.
He said, come, ask anything. So, no, when Jesus Christ said, ask anything, I will do it, it's true. The problem is that we don't have faith. The problem is that we don't trust him. The problem is that we don't know who God is. God, you are a powerful God. My eyes have seen, my ears have heard, my mouth will talk about what I saw. I have been seeing revelation, but this one I saw that it said Jehovah Nissi. I am coming to see the war, my brother, my sister. I don't know the war you are going through. I don't know the battle you are going through. Just asking God, come and see to yourself. Though he's seeing it, tell him to come down. He do come down. My people, if anybody from Nigeria is hearing me, all those headsmen killing, wherever there's war, let the people there in sincerity, because in that prayer we're praying, I saw sincerity. I saw people who are repenting of their sin. I saw people who want to make heaven. People who are serving God and they are ready for heaven. All we're thinking about, Father, okay, if it happened, let Father take help us. Help, Father, have mercy, have mercy, have mercy, please. This was the prayer everybody were praying. But he told me, I'm coming myself to see. And he came. People of God, God is handsome. He's handsome. Though he was an old man, you will know that this man is old man. But you, a young man of 2 years, is fresher than you. The skin of an old man. How I know he's old man, I don't know. But I know he's an old man. But the skin, we that are young, is finer, smoother. The smile alone is like a baby. The smile of this powerful God. And when he said, it is done. People of God, all you just need from God is, it is done.
Amen.
Nothing more. No matter the situation, if God can tell you it is done. Now I begin to know most things he has done for me in the past. I say, God, you are a wonderful God. Let the army of the whole universe join together. I don't think Apostle Manuel will be afraid again.
Amen.
Except he don't just want to come and do it. Except he don't want to fight the battle. Except he just, okay, let it happen. If he decide to fight that battle, if he decide to do that thing, if he decide to call for your aid, for your rescue, forget about it. And if you and I also decide to make our way right with him, because I am not exaggerating, in that revelation, I saw my heart was so open. I saw myself, all about me was God. All about me was, I can't explain it. There was nothing else in my brain, nothing else in my spirit. Everything about me, though there was war, everything about me was God. All about me was just God. Before I heard he spoke to me, he said, I am coming. I heard it clear, and I know the voice was from heaven. I look at heaven, he said, I am coming to see the war. If we can open up for God, forget about other things, forget about whatever, let God fill your heart, let God fill your mind, pull people away, pull hatred away, pull whatever away, pull I don't have this, I don't have that away, let God himself fill your heart. I tell you, God will speak, you will hear.
Amen.
God will come down, you will see him. God will manifest, you will see it. I have seen him, I am not exaggerating. I have seen him, I heard him, I saw his power. I know that Jehovah Nissi is powerful. He have done it in my, he have done many things to me in my life, but with what I saw now, When I got after this, I said, my wife, I cannot explain what I've just seen now. So what do you see? Say, it's already time for service. Brethren, please trust him. Trust Jehovah.
Jesus.
The Jehovah Nissi. Jehovah Nissi, the mighty man of war. Trust him. I don't know what you are going through. I don't know the situation. Please tell Nigerian Christians to repent of their sin. Pack away all those evil things in their altar. To take their mind away from death, from all those things. And come to God in sincerity as babies. Come to God as people who want to meet him in heaven. Come to God as people who are and cry to God for mercy. God Almighty will come down. Jehovah Nissi will come down. Under his seconds, we turn the battle against the enemy. Under a second, I did not see plane anywhere, they become powder. The smoke, how he dried the smoke up. And really, he recovered our land. Our land was bombarded. It became land again. How he did it, it is a mystery. I want to tell God, give me the grace to trust you. Give me the grace to love you. Give me the grace to put you inside of me. Give me the grace that everything I think about now is you. No matter the situation, to be all I have is you, Lord. All I think about is you. All I have is you. I want to pray to the Father, give me the grace. To love you, think about you alone, to trust you in every situation. Open your mouth. God is powerful. God is powerful.
Father, I believe your servants. Everything is set. Lord Jesus, you are Lord. There is no element of life. He just said, Father, Lord, I believe in you, Lord. I trust you, Lord. I believe you have showed to your servants. It's true, Lord. I you came to raise our faith up this morning, Jesus. Father, you are worthy. My Father, you are mighty. It's not everyone that will die. It's not everyone that will die.
God God that make it
when we trust in you, God, you we will believe in you. And Lord, Papa, you will not leave your children.
With the whole of our hearts, God, that you will direct our
path. With you, even to the end of the world.
Thank you, for coming down. You're sorry.
I have adopted you.
I have adopted you, Lord. I have for the way you have placed yourself. That no God. The way you are made,
Lord, everything is under your control.
You have given to us again.
I don't know
for your word you have planted in our heart again.
You
are blessed, God, who is like
you are wonderful, Lord.
Lord Jesus,
the Son Omega,
the everlasting God,
everything you create.
Father, I don't know how to appreciate
Help us to trust you, even when no hope is gone. We need not to trust you. All I need not to trust you. I'll be seeing you, Lord. In the name of Jesus. Because everything you created, Lord, is under your control. Help me, Lord.
Amen.
In Jesus' name we pray.
Amen.
Brethren, I have no reason not to trust God anymore.
Amen.
Yesterday in the evening, I spoke to Pastor Sunny. So I said, okay, since my parents said so, let's see how it will go. My mom would say, I'll call Sister Imade or something. I said, no, I can't do that. I was contemplating. But I'll say, but how? The other man was telling me, no, but with what I saw now, I can never beg again. I will never beg in my life again. I know God is
my
Amen.
I want you to pray. I say, Father, no matter the tempest, no matter the situation, the grace to look unto you, not to look unto man, not to lift my mind to man. Today, I receive that grace because I know even at the dying moment, if you trust him, he will come and manifest. Say, Father, today I receive the grace to take my eyes away from men and to put my eyes on you alone in the name of Jesus Christ.
Amen.
Father, when I look at situation, I look at things, oh God, I'm
discouraged.
Father, when I look unto you, I'm encourageable. When I look unto you, oh, my countenance changed for good. Ah, that I trust you, Lord God. I love you, Lord God, that you are able to do all things, God, because you are the unchangeable changer, the way maker. Ah, that the Lord, I have confidence in you. Father, Lord God, I bring you, Lord Jesus, because I trust you, Lord God, I believe in you, God, that you are the God Almighty that can do all things, God. Father, I remove my face away, Lord God, from situation. I remove my face away from men and women, and I focus on you, Lord. Father, I look unto you.
Every knee must bow.
When Jesus command
all power, all surrender,
when the God has my in every situation come out.
Oh, power, oh, surrender.
When that God that is not worried, when men are worried, come
on. Oh, power, even for surrender.
When God that smile, even inside the battle, come on. Hey, Papa.
Oh, power. Oh, surrender.
Men cry, weep in the battle.
But
I saw somebody smiling inside the battle. When men are crying and weeping, somebody was smiling. When bomb is landing everywhere, people are languishing. People are praying in fear. Somebody was inside there, smiling. Oh. Jesus Christ, enter me.
Jesus Christ, enter me.
When you enter you smile in everything. Say, Father, enter me. Enter this body.
And
I tell somebody here, from now on, no matter the situation, even when the boat is capsizing, you will sleep as Christ sleep.
Amen.
The Bible says disciples were in fear, but he was relaxing. Because he knows who he is. From today, the Lord will enter you, enter me. And no matter what the problem may be, where people be trying looking to see us crying, weeping, they will see us smiling and laughing in the name of Jesus Christ. Thank you, Jesus.
Thank you,
may your name be praised forever.
Amen.
I'm not worthy for you to show yourself to. I'm not worthy to even hear that voice, see that smiling face, see your action. I'm not worthy. It's a privilege. The grace of God not to misbehave. The grace of God to even humble myself more and more. I receive that grace today in the name of Jesus
Christ. Amen.
God, thank you, Safa. We can go over to you, Moderator.
Amen.
Praise